doing?
Your children have used all of our Wi-Fi and our data.
Do you
want to see this outrageous number that's on this bill? I don't think you do. I don't think you're ready for this. Look at how many zeros are on the end of that number.
And?
At least 7. This is absolutely outrageous. We got to come up with a plan. This has got to stop.
Well, where are you going?
No, I'll tell you the plan. They've got to go. That's the plan. They've got to go.
How are you going to do that?
Oh, you'll see. We're about to find out.
Will I?
Oh, you can't stop me either.
Oh my God, guess what?
What do you want? I'm trying to watch all 2 seasons of 13 Reasons Why in one day.
Our dads are like totally going to kick us out.
Why?
Because apparently $7,000 in the Wi-Fi bill is like a lot of money.
I don't even have enough to watch makeup tutorials.
Oh my God, this is so stupid.
Chargers so they can't charge their phones and or other devices. They can't get back home. This is the best news that I've received all of my life. God is on my side. I'm never going to see those little spawns of Satan again. Kids, get in here. We're going camping.
What are we doing?
Oh, don't look so enthused. We're going camping.
Great.
Hey, go pack your bags. We leave in an hour.
So, just an update on mine and Hunter's channel. We're now going camping with our family, and
it's gonna be fun.
I'm not asking about it.
We think they're onto something, so just like stay updated. So, our dads are clearly having a ton of fun. I think we're getting close to our campsite. So,
yeah,
we're not very excited.
Y'all go back to camp. We're gonna grab some supplies here. We'll be back before nighttime.
Here, you need this more than I do.
Well, let's go.
So we took a nap and we found some cows. And we're gonna use our GPS to make it back because we think our parents left us out here on purpose. Yeah, we all think our stepdad is behind it. So pesky squirrels throwing stuff. So we'll keep y'all updated. We're about to head back. We'll see how it goes.
Hey guys, so we're pretty much back at the house. We used our GPS to get back. It's just up ahead. We're gonna go walk in and talk to them. Hope all goes well. Peace out.
Well, we're back at the house and here goes nothing.
Hey dads.
What's up, y'all?
Oh, hello.
We're back from camping. It was really fun.
I'm so glad you made it back safely.
Y'all forgot about us.
Did we? No, y'all went to the wrong campsite. I'll be right back.
Well, they made it back from that. We left them in the middle of nowhere.
I don't know.
We're gonna have to take them further this time. I've got a plan.
Do you?
Oh, yes. Kids, come get your apple juice. Isn't this nice? We're all drinking together as a family. Down all of it. Make sure you drink every sip.
Okay, Dad.
Oh, wow, this one's kind of a thick one.
Trip.
Where are we?
Look, hey! It's our stepdad!
Yeah!
He just left us!
A few moments later.
So, we walked miles and miles, and we finally stumbled across this place, and it says it has free Wi-Fi. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go inside and see if we can't contact our dad and have him come. You ready to go?
Yep.
Because this doesn't seem sketchy at all. Let's go. Hi, can we get some Wi-Fi? We got lost in the woods and we need to contact our dad. Okay. So we logged onto the Wi-Fi and something really weird has happened. We're having to use our backup camera right now because our phones are completely
dead. Right now what my plan is to distract him so that we can get a hold of his computer and email our dad to get us out of here. So let's go.
Hey, do you have a charger I can borrow? My phone's in.
Yes, he is a hacker.
Isn't there another one of y'all?
Leaving me again.
Centuries ago, they would either be told orally or acted out in plays with actors and everything. And these stories were passed down generation and generation by word of mouth. Jacob and Wilhelm Grimm, the Grimm brothers, were born and raised in Germany in the late 18th century, actually. They studied German literature, language, and folklore at the University of Marbury. And, they would eventually collect folklore, like German folklore, and they would publish them in volumes. Stories like Hansel and Gretel, Cinderella, Snow White, Sleeping Beauty, and a lot more were popularized through their books. The first volume was published in 1812, and the last one in 1857, so it went on for a long time. And, their stories are still being adapted today in TV shows like Grimm, or even movies like Cinderella, other Disney princess movies like Snow White, stuff like that.
It is safe to say that we definitely strayed from our storyboard when creating our video. A main reason for this is we got to the filming location and we realized that just some things wouldn't work, and the entrances and the exits just didn't line up with our storyboard. So that was the first thing that we encountered. Once we got to where we were filming and we kind of figured out what we wanted to say and got our script down and started blocking where we were gonna be, we kind of just fixed it from there and ad-libbed for the most part. We added in a lot of our own jokes, a lot of our own comments, and one of the biggest scenes in our video is when Hunter and Gabriella get drugged and, you know, taken off into the field and left there by their stepfather. And that was completely drawn up last minute. We had no intention of that scene ever being in there until about 5 minutes before it was done, just because we're sitting there bouncing ideas off of each other. What could happen? What could happen? Is this really what we want to happen? And so much can change just with, you know, new ideas and the feeling and the environment of the room that we didn't really look at our storyboard once we started filming. The only thing looking back on it that really stayed the same was the locations and the general, you know, areas that our storyboard took place. But other than that, we just were taking ideas and running with them. In our version of Hansel and Gretel, Hunter and Gabriella, our main focus was to entertain the modern audience, and we did this in three ways. We incorporated technology, which just completely revamped the old fairy tale. We added cell phone overages and data hacking and just different things that happen in today's society, and we thought that would just be a cute way and a fun way to take a spin on this classic fairy tale. The second way we did this is through comedy. A lot of what you see in our video was just us ad-libbing and just having fun with it. And we thought that, you know, just ad-libbing here and there and putting our own spin on our script that we wrote would just give us a way to personally reach the audience and, you know, kind of just have that connection that you wouldn't have if you just read a script and just did this and did this and did this. And so that was just a big thing that we really wanted to do. We, you know, we made ourselves laugh. And we thought if we can make ourselves laugh while working on a project, surely we can make others laugh. And the third way that we planned on entertaining the modern audience was to have a vlog style point of view. Now, this is kind of untraditional, especially with the examples that we've seen and just different things that we've researched, and especially by the way that the original was told, because, you know, it was told by strictly a third person point of view. Vlogging is something that is very popular on YouTube, on different social media accounts, and I know that me and my peers, we all enjoy this, and we know that this is something that's very popular among teens nowadays, and we thought this would just be a really fun way to incorporate something that a lot of teens enjoy watching and enjoy doing themselves. We thought it would be really unique to incorporate Hunter and Gabriella's point of view along with a third person point of view. This just kind of gives diversity in our scenes and diversity in, you know, watching.
So the process I took to assembling the video was the normal way I do creating any kind of video that I do. I start out by laying down the base foundation, which is syncing up the clips and getting together the base video. So if all else fails, I at least have some kind of video to use. But I do this first, and then after that, then I'll go and, like, you know, add effects, add sounds, add titles and all that. But I didn't really get to do that on this because I ran into a big problem, and that was my program failing multiple times, and it would just shut down and wouldn't let me interact with any type of media I had on there. And so I spent about 8 hours just sitting here waiting for it to work with me, and I would be able to do maybe one thing every 30 minutes. So I would probably say that that's the biggest problem I ran into, is that it took a lot of time out of extra things that I could have done to it. I would have to say that it's a lot like our similar idea, or our first idea. We did build off of one main idea, and then if we didn't have things in the video, we would build off of it then and come up with things on the spot, which helped be beneficial because we were enjoying it and what we were doing we liked and we thought was good in the moment, or we would redo something. I would have to say that I'm satisfied with the final project. Although I didn't have as much time to work with it as I would like to, I'm satisfied for what I did have time to do. And although I did have lots of delays, I still managed to make something that I enjoyed making.